For tonight, a story of survival and defying the odds.
Tonight, a Florissant woman is making what doctors call a miraculous recovery after being hit by a car. 45-year-old Jennifer Ewers was walking her two dogs near Patterson and Limedale Saturday night when she was hit.
Only News 4's Emma Hogue spoke with her husband. Emma is live tonight in our studio.
Corey, Claire, right now Jennifer is going on day four in the ICU. First was surgery on her spine, and today was an operation on her lungs. No doubt her recovery will take weeks, if not months, but tonight her husband is just grateful she survived.
I can't explain it, but it's given me peace.
For decades, Clay Ewers says his faith has meant
everything. I wouldn't be here without it.
But instead of praying at his home parish, the deacon at First Christian Church is asking for help inside this chapel at SLU Hospital.
Prayer, lots of prayer.
His wife Jennifer, just down the hall, undergoing her second major surgery in 4 days. The mother of two was hit by a car near Patterson and Limedale Sunday night while walking their two dogs.
As soon as I saw the emergency lights at the end of the street, I figured something had gone wrong.
Ewers was at home two blocks away and arrived just as his wife was being rushed to the emergency room. Their dog Buster survived, but Toby was killed.
Their spine was separated and her lung was bleeding. She had a compound fracture, her femur, and then the rest of her just beat up.
In fact, he says doctors told him 98% of patients with her injuries end up paralyzed. Tonight, she's still able to move her arms and legs.
Nothing short of a miracle.
As Jennifer recovers, support from their church community is pouring in. Donations and well wishes, along with the hashtag JenStrong.
Well, they've been incredible. It's overwhelming.
Tonight, as his wife heals, Ewers is grateful for this chapel until the two can get back to the church they call home.
I know she's strong and she's fighting, so she's not gonna be like this forever.
And tonight, police are still investigating what led to this crash. We do know that driver stayed on scene and is cooperating with investigators. If you'd like to help the Ewers family, there is a donation page. You can find that link on our KMOV news app. In the studio, Emma Hogue, News 4.